At the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High.
Hi, I am Dr. Amalia S. Natividad, a registered nutritionist dietitian. I am an instructor in one of the colleges in Cavite. I am teaching nutrition and dietetic subjects, and I also authored the modules used in the training of these future nutritionist dietitians. I would like to share to you this topic on how to be smart on food and nutrition. Our aim here, of course, is to be healthy and be more knowledgeable in terms of food safety and preparation of food items in order for us not to be infected with COVID-19 as we are really experiencing now. Okay, so lack of wisdom. Okay, as the Lord said, people perish for lack of wisdom. How to be smart? To be smart is to have an ability, a knowledge. You have an exceptional intelligence, no? Wherein you know how to plan your meals, how to prepare, to cook, to purchase, to serve food nutritionally, efficiently, and of course, it is of safe food items, no? Okay. So, to be smart, you should know the basic concepts of nutrition. It is very important that we learn this. Okay? Try to understand this better for us to be more equipped with all this knowledge. Number one concept is this. Nutrition is the food you eat and how the body uses it. We eat food to live, to grow, to keep healthy and well, and to get energy for work and play. Nutrition is the food you eat and how the body uses it. You are what you eat. Anong ibig ko sabihin niyo? Kung madalas ka ang puro kinakain mo ay outside foods or yung mga nasa fast foods like fried chicken, okay, french fries potato, most likely what will happen? No? Tumataas ang iyong cholesterol. No? And then yung calories mo. Okay, you're adding more of your calories, therefore, tumataba ka. Bumibigat ka ng bumibigat. Okay, so please say no to that. Okay, what else? Okay, kapag hindi ka masyadong kumakain ng gulay, puro ka na lang karne. Hindi ka nagkakaroon ng regular bowel movement. Okay, wala kang fiber eh. Okay, you're not eating fruits and vegetables. Okay, you are not helping your body to have a higher immune system. Madali kang magkasakit. Okay, hindi balanse kasi ang kinakain mo, no? So therefore, ano solution natin yan? Is to really eat variety of foods or well-balanced diet. Meaning to say, we really have to have these 6 very important nutrients, no? Yung carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals, and water. Okay? So please take note of that. Okay? So nutrition, we eat food in order to live, okay? To grow. Kaya mapapansin nyo, itong mga infants, ano? Ang daling lumaki. Bakit? Kahit na breast milk lang ng nanay yan, no? Sa umpisa. Kita mo, no? Nag-expand na yung katawan niya, no? Bigla na lang nagko-crawl, okay? Nakikipag-usap sa'yo, nagre-respond, because of this meal, In the same manner with, if we are really eating balanced diet, okay? So, number two concept, food is made up of different nutrients needed for growth and health. All nutrients needed by the body are available through food. Take note of this. many kinds and combination of foods can lead to a well-balanced diet. No. Ano ibig sabihin nun, no? If you will be serving your family with tenderloin steak, dapat merong buttered vegetable yun. At least you have cream or potato soup perhaps, no? Okay? And then you have your, what do you call this? Garlic spaghetti. No? Meron ka nun, no? And then you're giving them the pressed fruits in season, no? Okay? Yung prutas, no? So, ibig sabihin, nababalanse mo, meron kang carbohydrates, meron kang proteins, meron kang fats na ginamit mo sa paggawa ng iyong tenderloin steak, no? Okay? And then, of course, meron kang vitamins and minerals from the fruits and vegetables, okay? So, we really have to have a good combination, especially when preparing the food. Ito pa, no food by itself has all the nutrients needed for full growth and development. No. Wala dang nag-iisang nutrients na puro for full growth and development. As I said, kailangan ng combinations, no? Okay. So take note of this. Carbohydrate is the sole source energy for the brain and nerve tissues, no? That's why in a certain pasta or perhaps rice, no? Okay? Mention carbohydrates and the B complex. Okay? So, it is there intact. And then what else, no? Paano ka ba ipapaliwanag ito? Not all the nutrients needed are for full growth and development, no? Okay? So, tingnan mo. Itong protina natin, wala naman siya vitamin C, no? Yung makinakain mong chicken, beef, pork, no? Eggs, wala siyang vitamin C. Therefore, you should really eat fruits and vegetables. Ito namang fruits and vegetables, ha? I should say, no, yung fruits, no? Entirely, wala naman siyang protina. So, you really have to take in this, no? So, you need really a variety of foods. Okay. Ano itong mga function na ito? Maliwanag, no? Carbohydrate is the one that makes you be energetic and active, no? As I said, no? Carbohydrates, no? Kailangan sa ating brain functions, okay? And then, what else, no? Protein builds and repairs body tissues. Itong protein na to, siya ang nagpo-form ng antibodies. Okay? Pag kumakain sufficient ang protein mo, ha? Most likely, no? Your antibodies will be important. No? Okay? And then, hormone formation then. Hemoglobin, and then enzyme, no? So, napaka-importante, no? We have protein in the diet also. And then, what else? Fats, no? Yung healthy fats. Mas maganda nang you're using vegetable fats at home, no? Okay? Ano yung mga sources na yan, no? You have olive oil. Okay? Canola oil, soya oil, no? Kasi coconut is the only plant source. Okay, which is really saturated in nature. Ano ibig sabihin niya is it's bad cholesterol. Ano merong good cholesterol? Ito yung mga, as I said, no? Yung mga vegetable. Yan ang gamitin natin. Bakit? We need fats also, aside from giving energy. Our organs are covered by fats. Yan ang gumagawa niya, no? Kino-cover niya, no? Tingnan mo to. Pag sobra-sobra ang kinakain mong fats, no? Na-overload na ng cholesterol and triglyceride. Okay? And then what happened? Okay? Nagkakaroon ka ng problema sa iyong blood pressure. Tumataas ang iyong BP or yung dugo mo, no? Okay? So, please take note of that. And then, of course, these vitamins and minerals which we can find in fruits and vegetables, no? It regulates body processes, no? Kita mo, makikita mo yung aura mo, yung maganda mata mo, yung fair skin, yung eyes mo bouncy, you have a nice posture, you seem to be energetic, beautiful. Why? Because of these fruits and vegetables. So, tingnan mo, no? Kaya ito mga beauty contestants, most likely, they eat more of fruits and vegetable. Aside from that, okay, itong fiber na tinatawag, napaka-importante, a source of carbohydrate. So, you know, we have simple and complex carbohydrate. Okay? Ito complex carbohydrate, saan yung matatagpuan, no? We call that rapids, no? Starch and rapids, no? Sa banana, sa corn, no? Okay? And then, what else? Yung mga tubers, potato. Okay? So, maganda yan sa sistema ng ating katawan, no? Fiber, what are these fiber? Okay? The parts of plants where we do not digest anymore, no? Okay? Dire-diretso yan. Kaya, it has a cleansing effect, no? Okay? Ano nangyayari sa katawan natin, no? We have a regular bowel movement, no? Nag-cleanse ng ating guts and ating digestive system. Okay? And of course, yung metabolism natin, nagiging normal. Okay? What is metabolism? It is the chemical changes taking place in our body the moment we eat these foods. Okay? So, that's it, no? So, fiber really is very important. It acts as what? Sweeper. Ng pagwawalis ng cholesterol. Minawalis yung salt. Tignan mo yan, no? Nalilinisan ka. Nagiging very comfortable ka in a day's work. No? Okay. What else, no? So, most nutrients do their best work in the body when teamed with other nutrients. Ito, kaganda to. You see, when you are playing basketball, you act as team mo. No? Kasi merong guard, merong forward, merong nag-shoot. No? Okay. So, tingnan natin, merong umaalala, no? As I said. No? So, ganun din sa pagkain. No? Yung calcium na to, kailangan niya ng vitamin B. Okay? Para sa good bone and teeth development. No? Sa bone structure. Sa muscular need natin, no? Some muscles, no? Okay? And then what else? This iron and protein, no? When thin. Okay? Nakaka-create siya ng maayos na hemoglobin natin. Yan. And then of course with vitamin C pa rin, no? Kaya nga tingnan natin, no? Nagiging maayos, healthy ating katawan, and aside from that, no? We do not get sick so easily. Okay? Hindi ka madaling mapagod. You have a good night's sleep. Okay? Parang you're so comfortable every day's work, no? So, okay. Yun ang sinasabi natin. Okay, number three concept. Huwag niyo kalimutan to. All persons throughout life have the need for the same nutrients but in varying amount. So, all persons throughout life, starting from a pregnant woman, up to the elderly. Okay. We need all this news, but in varying amounts. Okay. Yung weight or measure ng pagkain, no? Okay? Is really influenced by age, no? Sex, size, activities, and the state of health, no? Okay. So, what do you mean by this? By age, no? Okay. Pag ikaw ay medyo matanda na, hindi ka pwedeng kumain ng maraming karne. Fried chicken, tenderloin steak, no? Callos madrileña. Okay? Or any that you need for protein, no? Hindi na pwede. May limitation, no? You must have at least 1.12 grams per kilogram body weight, no? Okay? Medyo talagang alalay, no? Bakit? Pag sumusobra ka niyan, ha, tumataas ang iyong uric acid. Therefore, nagkakaroon ka ng rayuma, ha, arthritis, okay, osteoporosis, osteomalacia, you name it. Okay? Unlike for the teenagers, no? Ha, ang measure ng pagkain niya, okay, they can really take pa kay even 1.5 cups of mongo. Okay? Yung infant naman, kahit na konti lang, ay, maybe, yung 4 months na to, bibigyan mo siya ng 1/4 teaspoon, no? May enough B-complex na yun. And then, at the same time, yung protein, no? Okay? So, all of us are really in need of this nutrient, but in varying amounts. Okay? So, clear natin yun, no? Okay? So, iba-iba. Okay. And then, age yun, no? And then, next, sex. Okay. Tingnan nyo to. Yung mga teenagers, boys and girls. Ha? Sino ang mas dapat kumain ng marami? Ha? To add further calories. Yung mga boys. Bakit? Kasi iba yung activities nila. Eh. Nagbabasketball sila. Eh, tayo pa, gym-gym lang, no? Ha? Yung mga adolescent girls, no? Okay? So, and then they really lift heavy things, no? Oh, nagpupwersa sila with their muscles, no? Unlike girls, hindi, no? So, okay. It really is an influence. Yung sex din, no? And what else, no? Activities. Okay, pag heavy activities, like boxing. Okay, you need more of calories. Okay. Pero pag natapos na yung boxing mo, hindi ka na nag-workout, pa konti-konti na lang. Okay? Dapat, ano na siya, babaguhin mo na yung rate mo, no? Okay? You will be using a sedentary activity in terms of percentage use, no? Okay? Sa caloric requirement, no? It becomes 35 calories per kilogram body weight, no? Okay. Ibigyan mo kayo ng idea on how to compute that in the next vlogs, no? Perhaps, no? You will see. Okay? And then, of course, ha? Ano pa ang nakaka-influence? Yung body size, no? Of course, pag genetically, malaki ka, ay, matangkad ka, you need more of calories, no? Okay? So, it's really very important to know that. And then, of course, yung state of health. Okay? Ano bang ibig sabihin ng nutritional status? No? Okay. The condition of your body health and your state of nutrition. Importante yun, no? Kung ikaw yung masakit, eh, perhaps meron kang tinamaan ka ng COVID-19, okay, you need more of vitamin Z, no? Zinc, vitamin A, C, E, zinc, vitamin B. Okay? So, you need this, no? Okay? So, kinakailangan yan. Depending on the state of health. Pag ikaw naman na matanda, eh, mayroon kang rayuma. Okay? So, ililimit mo ngayon, yung, as I said, no, yung protein intake mo. And then, foods higher in purine, ha? Yung mga laman loob, no? Okay? Yung mga seeded vegetables, no? So, yun, no? It is very important to know that. Ha? Ha? Magkaroon tayo ng knowledge, ha? Tungkol this different factors, okay? Number 4 concept is this. The way food is handled influences the amount of nutrients in food, its safety, appearance, and taste. Okay. So, handling means everything that happens to food when it is being what? Purchased? Okay? Prepared at home, cook, and then stir. And storing, of course. No? Okay, ano ibig sabihin niyan? Yung nutrients na makukuha natin, depende to on how do we really keep our food safe, and then retention of nutrients is being harvested. No? Okay. Kung maayos ang iyong pagluluto, okay, ng gulay, ha? Makikita mo yung yellow green, ha? Hindi what do you call this na so overcooked yung gulay, then you can really get the nutrient, no? Halimbawa, pag namalengke ka naman, bumili ka ng kangkong, ha? 10 piso yung bundle, binigay sa 5 piso pero 10 kilo, no? Kahit nakainim yung 10 kilo na yon, ha? Na kangkong na wilted na, dry na, kulubot na. Ha? Wala na yung makikita mong freshness. Ha? Pag kahit nakainin, as I said, kahit nakainin mo sa 10 kilo na yan, eh, you cannot cut the important vitamins and minerals, particularly vitamin A and iron. No? Okay? And vitamin C. No? Okay? As I said, no, do not forget, no? Itong green leafy and yellow vegetables are rich in vitamin C. Ha? Ang alam lang natin may vitamin C itong mga prutas, mga nanay ko, no? Even yung malunggay may vitamin C, magnesium, and more of important minerals and vitamins. Okay. And then pag mali naman i-storing procedures mo, Okay? Halimbawa, itong mga pecha, nilagay mo sa freezer. Oh, di ba? Ay, hindi okay ang pag-storage mo, no? So, na-apektuhan yung sustansya or the nutrients we can get from the food. So, dapat, you must have really following how to really prepare this food item. And likewise, we have to prevent foodborne diseases. Okay? Ano ba yung madaling tamaan ng COVID-19, no? Yung mahina ng immune system, no? Bakit, no? Sa payan, pag nagkaroon ka ng foodborne diseases, no? Ano ba yun? Yung mga nakukuha natin sa pagkain when we cook, no? Okay? Itong mga limbawa, no? Yung na-contaminate, yung isang kusinero. Oh, are you cooking? May sipon ka. Okay? Yung virus, yung sipon na yan, eh, napunta doon sa ginagawa mo. Okay, what happened? Pag kinain yun, eh, contaminated na yun. Okay, madali may food contamination, no? Okay, one surface area, okay, to another. Nagkakaroon ng growth of microorganism. Perhaps bacteria, virus, okay, and all other germs, no? So be careful, no? Huh? That's why it's really very important you to be healthy. Okay, wala kang sakit when you are preparing foods. No? And then, you really follow the safety rules. Ano yung mga yan, no? Ha? Tapos you're washing your hands before preparing the foods. No? And then, your garbage disposal is really, you're working it out, no? Okay? And then, of course, ang environment mo ay malinis, no? Okay, you're using water is really good for cooking, no? So, okay, ha? So, napaka-importante yan, ha? So, please take note of that. So, when it comes to nutrient loss, no? From cooking, okay? Lalo na itong mga fruits and vegetables, be careful, okay? Halimbawa, when you are really having a dinner, no? Ang ulam ninyo is sinigang na perhaps na salmon, no? So, dapat yung kamoy, any vegetables, no? Okay, when you're on the table, doon na ilalagay yung vegetable, no? Sandali lang, and then before you eat that. Okay? So, ganun yun, no? So, proper and reliever is to be followed, no? Okay. In summary, be smart in what? Okay? In planning of the food. Okay? In purchasing. In storing, in preparing, cooking, and serving. And take note, the ultimate goal of this nutrition must be followed, no? Of this meal management. One is really to keep or prepare foods, no? Nutritionally. Pangalawa, safely. Pangatlo, efficiently. Ah, yung tatlo na yan, no? With good nutrition, malinis, no? Safely, efficient, no? Tamang pamaraan, tamang time to really give for your family to deserve, no? Okay? So, yun yun. So, tatandaan natin, no? Sa pamagitan nito, knowing all of this, you will become smart. Okay? Ano naman magiging resulta nito? We will avoid ourselves from infected with this coronavirus. And we will have a very high immune system. No? And we can really work and be productive. Beautiful and prosperous. Okay, that's all for today. Hi! Thank you for watching my blog. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and click the notification below. For more updates and for more upcoming videos, see me in my next blog. God bless you all!